guys, welcome to my channel. So 2020 is coming to an end and I just thought of taking up one good habit. Maybe I'm gonna keep up to it. So you must have read by the title that I'm going to do journaling today. So now, if you don't know what journaling is basically, you know, trying to pour out all your heart out into a book or a diary. So basically, some people write diaries, that is also journaling, but artist way of journaling is to make it more beautiful and creative. So recently I received a dotted grid notebook from Factor Notes. It is a store on Instagram, you should definitely check them out. They have some amazing books. I will link them in the description. So they sent me their one of the dotted grid books and I just thought it would be the perfect thing for me to start journaling now. So I am going to share one spread of my journal today with you guys. So now let's just get into the video and do some little creative journaling.
So this is the dotted grid book that I received from Factor Notes. It is really in a pretty lavender color and is dotted from inside, as you can see. So I just decided to start this journal, start this notebook with my journaling process, and I'm using these scrap papers that I had lying around. I'm using all of these fall type colors because I wanted it to look like that, and I'm using some washi tapes. That's totally up to you. I'm also using some brush pens and different types of liner pens. You can use anything that you have at home. Everything in journaling is up to you and it is totally like scrap. So you can use anything that you have lying around. So I started by tearing out some pages randomly with my hand and not properly with the scissors because I wanted that rough look. So you can go ahead with scissors if you want like crisp edges, but I really like it in this way, so I am just doing that. And I just decided to put like this black border on both the pages, so that is what I'm doing here. I have just taken out this black paper and, you know, tore it using just my hands. And it looks pretty cool and I really like it how it looks like that. So I really like collecting these small types of diaries, and I had this one from long back, so I am just tearing out one paper from it because I thought it would look, it will give a very nice touch to the whole page, and I'm going to just stick this page right above the black border. I am using this double-sided tape from Scoobu. It is also an Instagram store. They were very kind enough to send me their products and this tape is really, really nice. Then to just, you know, add a little bit color and floral element, I am just using this very beautiful washi tape. Now you will not be able to find it here, maybe because I got this one from Shein, but you can totally find more washi tapes from Amazon. I am going to link some really cute ones in the description below. Now, one benefit of dotted grid is that you don't really need a scale and you can go ahead and make straight lines using the dots as your guide. So that is what I did here. I just made a box, and to give a little 3D look to it, that I have pasted it on the paper, I am just adding small pieces of the tape on the two corners, so it gives a look as if that you have taken an external paper and pasted it on your sheet. So this is a very easy way to, you know, mimic or portray that you're using different papers. Then again, I'm going ahead with different color paper. It's a tan, beautiful tan color, and I'm going to stick it in the bottom right corner. I also had this very nice mustard yellow colored paper. This is actually from a very, very old file from my school or college, I guess, and it had lines all over it, so I just really liked how it looked, and I'm just going to paste it just next to the tan one. So the whole idea about journaling is to just, you know, try to match different type of contrasting colors, and it gives a very good look if you just, you know, place have a like a similar color scheme going on in your whole spread, but at the same time the colors should look good together. So I try to use all the fall colors and I think they look very, very pretty. Lastly, I'm using this very, very nice maroon colored paper. I don't know, I couldn't find any more in the market, but thankfully I had very little piece left of this one, so I am just using that in the top corner. And I also added washi tapes here and there just to give a little good look. Now I had this fall type colors washi tape because I bought this whole collection of washi tapes which was actually listed as a fall collection, so I have all of these fall colors in the washi tapes. If you don't have that, you can totally change your color scheme also.
I was really skeptical about what to put in the journal because you know, it's really confusing. So many people use journals in different form of ways, like my own planner that I have launched is used as is a form of a journal only, where I have incorporated to-do lists, habit trackers, budget trackers, monthly trackers and many things like that. By the way, it's still on sale, link in description. So as I was saying, that many people use journals in different form of ways. I thought of using my journal's first page, like I'm starting with December, so I wanted my first page to look a little motivating and inspiring for me.
So I am just using my calligraphy skills here a little bit, but if you don't know calligraphy, don't be shy to make a journal, because journal is only for you. No one is gonna read it. So you can go ahead and write in any way you want to, in any handwriting. So lately I have been really hard on myself in getting things done. So I just wanted to write this quote for myself and remind myself to not be so hard on myself and just be, you know, calm. This whole spread is going to be just something like that, right? Like writing quotations and motivational things that I want to hear from myself, so that whenever I open this journal, I can you know, calm myself down and not worry about every single thing. So I am just writing the randomest of things, and if you guys want like a proper picture, if you want to see that what all is written and everything, I'm not hiding anything from anyone, but you can go ahead and check out the picture on my Instagram. I might have uploaded this, or I will be uploading it today definitely, so make sure you check it out. And the box that I made previously, remember, I am just going to use it to write some quotations that I actually saw on Pinterest. Also, cut to this little floral or botanical illustration. I really like these very, very much, and I think they look so positive and they look so beautiful. So I'm using my white pen. This pen is from Sakura, and I am using it to make little floral illustrations. So as I was telling, that I am writing some pointers in this dabba, or in this box that I found on Pinterest. I am not making all of these lines up. I found this whole big quotation on Pinterest, and I just thought that it's really nice. So I just wanted to write that completely in the whole box. And then I also decided to, you know, add the song that is actually on top of my playlist right now. I'm really, really enjoying this song these days, and I listen to this one a lot. So I just thought I'll do a little doodle of that song here. And frankly, by this point, I was exhausted and I didn't want to do anything. So I just chose this little quote and I have written it all over. So I was a little lazy then. So yeah, basically just telling you that do journaling when you want to, and if you don't want to, you can fill it up with anything. It's your journal, it's your call, do anything you want to. And that is my whole fall related spread.
About the whole spread, I am so happy how it turned out. It looks so beautiful. I actually used to do a lot of scrapbooking previously on order basis. Recently I've not done any scrapbooking, but this really did take me down that memory lane, and I'm so happy I did this. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please go ahead and make your own journals. Try to do this creative process. It's really satisfying and motivating and calming at the same time. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel. I hope 1k very soon. I'm really trying that. So yes, also press the bell button next to the subscribe button so that you don't miss any of my videos. Follow me on my Instagram, follow that DIYMiss, which is my Instagram store. As I said, a new product is going to launch soon, or I think it might have launched, I'm not sure. But make sure you check it out, and I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye.